Now, I'm going to read you something, okay? Put my glasses on, all right? Now, listen to this, folks. Listen. You don't understand. You don't know the game. It's all right. Let's go. And now
I got a little postcard. Yeah, this Canadian icon has been telling it like it is for more than 30 years of as co-host of Coach's Corner, and with his newest book, Hockey Greats and More, Don Cherry explores not just the best on the ice, but other athletes at their prime of their game. Please welcome the man, the legend. Can we say that, Don Cherry?
Legend in my own mind.
And ours, too. We're going to say it as well. Thank you very much for joining us today.
Happy to be here.
And you were just talking. Oh.
All right.
We were talking about bagpipers because we just Remembrance Day is coming up, and I know how important that is to you.
Yes, I was a member for 7 years. I was a tenor drum in the Rochester City Pipe Band. We were the best dressed. We looked terrific. We had the big bonnets, and everything was brand new. So I was very proud to be in the pipe band. I saw him. I thought he was here for me.
Still the best dressed.
Yeah.
Oh, I was thinking, do I have anything I could come close to? No, I'm not going to compete.
McLean okay. tries, but.
It's not close, is
no,
it?
No.
All right. Fifth book.
Yes.
Who's in it? Who's your favorites in this that you love telling a story about?
Well, I have Phil. We have Dave the Hammer Schultz. We have Terry O'Reilly. I would say Terry O'Reilly's my favorite in it. And you know how tough he was.
He was, yeah.
He had, there he is there. I think we're showing it here. I'll tell you one thing. He had, I didn't know it. I picked it up that fast. How did you do? I didn't tell. And he had 200 minutes in penalties. He was our leading goal scorer in a first-place club. And he would never talk about his fights. He'd asked him after. He said, I don't want to talk about fights. And his hobby was stained glass. You know,
really?
Yeah. And he would never talk about fights. And he never, ever ran after anybody. He never went looking for a fight. But if you were ready, he was a wild Irishman. He wanted to go. And he scored big goals for us. And I was quite proud. So I think he was my favorite in there.
And Phil Esposito, where you think he's so underrated, don't you?
Well, Phil,
or doesn't get the respect he should.
Well, no, he got 65 goals and 76 goals. I remember after he got 65 goals, after 76, you're having a bad year. 65 goals, you're having a bad year. And I don't think they ever went after Phil. I never think he got the recognition. Then he went to New York, and after he left Bobby, he got 30 goals, which 30 goals back in those days was nothing.
It was a startup at that point, wasn't it? Where do you how do you have more stories? Well, you've told so many stories. How do you have more?
Well, it's my son. I have to say it's my son's idea. We were out looking at a minor midget as we always do, and what happened was we went back. We were freezing, like you guys were outside there.
Yes, we were.
He said, "What? We get all those stories." He said, "We should write a book." And it was my son Timothy, and We just got like Terry O'Reilly, and we got the interviews, and we got all the stuff. So we got all the good stuff out of it. And my son Tim was the driving force behind it.
And you looked out beyond hockey in this one.
Well, we did.
Talk about some players. Your story about Josh Donaldson, I was laughing out loud reading.
Yeah, I tell you, it was the funny thing. A lot of people he said, "I'm going to make you look good." And I said, I am so nervous. You had 50,000 people. I'm so nervous.
You're out throwing this
the first
ball.
Pitch. And I was really nervous. And there he goes there. What a guy he was. He had a bad year last year. He says, he's going to make me look good. I said, why? How are you going to make me look good? And what happened was I threw it, and it was going to hit before the plate. And he ran out and caught it. And it made me look like I knew what I was doing.
Yeah.
But I was very nervous. And Josh Donaldson had an awful year last year. He was injured the whole time. And I'm a real baseball. I'm not A and Jeff Blair. I am really, really into baseball, and I'm so unhappy that he had a bad year. But he'll bounce back next year. And Boston won, by the way. That's what
yes, they did. Do you cheer for Boston?
My son Tim and I, we used to go to Fenway all the time, and I knew the guys there and everything. And I knew one of the owners, Bobby Orr's golf tournament. He brought me the hat, and he said we're going to win it this year, and they did.
Yeah.
What do you do for Remembrance Day? It's coming up. What is your day like for Remembrance Day?
I go into a few rinks and things like that, and I don't like to talk about it because it's nothing to what I do. And I remember my grandmother always talked about Sergeant Thomas William McKenzie. He was killed 4 days before the end of the war, wow. November 7th. He was in it the whole time, and so when I think, and I hope everybody, I'm glad to see everybody in the place wearing a poppy. When I go downtown and I don't see people wearing a poppy, and I think of all they give their life and everything for it, and some people can't buy a poppy. I don't think they understand And the poppy is down. The selling them is down because the Legion, you know, the guys are getting older and the Legions are closing and it's not, they're not pushing it. So if you see anybody selling it or you go to the gas stations or those places like that, yeah, throw $5 in and it helps all the families.
To get the kids involved.
It is. Well, I think they are more and more now. I get letters from high schools and that they're teaching them about the war. I mean, 20 years ago, nobody even knew we were in a war, and we were the best soldiers in the world. We were volunteers. Mm. Now, you see the other, I'm not knocking the other armies, but we were all volunteers. When you see the guys over there fighting, and if you've ever fought somebody that likes to fight or wants to fight, it's a lot different than fighting the guy that, as you know. So I hope everybody buys a poppy.
Thank you very much for coming in today. I appreciate
happy to
it.
Be here.
Hockey Thank greats you very much for having and me. More. Yeah, a pleasure. Here. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Hockey greats and more. You can get your own signed copy when Don visits Chapters Oshawa November the 21st at 7 p.m. Head to our website for a full list of upcoming signing events and where you can meet Don. BreakfastTelevision.ca. We've got more coming up after the break. We're talking instant family. Thank you very much, sir.